Hey guys, so today we're doing a Will I Buy It video. A big, big, big thank you to Samantha March who started these videos, and also a huge congratulations to Samantha March. She just reached 100,000 subscribers here on YouTube, which is such a huge milestone for YouTubers. They get like a plaque from YouTube and it's just such a great feeling. So congratulations to Samantha on that. And let's go ahead and dive into some new releases. All right, so I'm referring to some of my favorite Instagram accounts here. I'm gonna start with TrendMood1. She always has the best info on the widest range of products. So I see the first thing in her feed is a new, what is this? This, I'm like so intrigued now. This is some new Hourglass products. New family members to the At Night shade. It's now a collection by Hourglass. It includes an ambient lighting blush, which is new. And this blush looks really beautiful. It looks like a burnt red color, which I happen to really enjoy for blushes. There's also a number new 28 lip treatment oil in this At Night shade, and that is new. And then the Confession refillable lipstick, I think that was existing. And I think maybe that's what the blush and the lip oil is sort of based off of. It looks like it's gonna be available August 12th on the Hourglass website. I think I definitely wanna try that blush out. I'm not the biggest fan of the Hourglass Confession lipstick. They're very silicone-y, so they go on really slick and smooth, but I feel like they really dry out my lips after a while. And then the lip treatment oil, I already have three of those, which I need to start using a little bit more. And I have Icon, which is their like Hourglass's like primary red. So I think I'm good with lip oils, but I definitely wanna try this blush. I think that looks very, very pretty, especially for the fall season. And it looks like it's kind of swirled with something a lot lighter and a lot more shimmery, which I really enjoy in terms of Hourglass blushes. Their blushes are one of my favorites. So I think I'm definitely gonna pick up that blush. That looks really, really nice. I don't see any pricing info. I'm gonna assume that the blush and everything is the same price as the existing line already. So we'll see, but no pricing information at the moment. Let's move on to, So this is actually available now. This is a new Bite Beauty lip set. So this is the Millennial Pink's Mini Clean Lip Crayon Set. I love a lip crayon, you guys know that. It looks like it comes with four different crayons. I really like that they're mini. It looks like there's three new pink shades. So this set is limited edition. It looks like there's three new pink shades in their Power Move Creamy Matte Lip Crayon formula and one best-selling shade, and it all comes in this metallic rose gold collectible tin. Well, the fact that all of these are matte, I'm probably gonna pass on these. I really like the packaging though, it's so cute, but I'm gonna pass on these. I just don't wear matte lip products often at all, so yeah, I'm gonna pass on these. But this looks really, really cute, and again, it's already available. It's $39 for the four-piece set. All right, next up, I saw these Burberry face palettes all over Instagram, and I was like losing my mind trying to find them, and then I realized they're only available in Europe at the moment. So I think they're coming to the US soon. We don't really have a date yet, and I don't really have a price because right now all I see is that they're available for £62. So I don't know what they're gonna do in terms of dollars, but it looks like there are two different color stories for this face palette. One looks a little bit warmer, one looks a little bit cooler, and it looks like, oh, okay, I see. So both face palettes have two highlighters, two blushes, and then two kind of like sculpting contour shades. I was confused because in the cooler one, the one on the left, the lower like left-hand corner, which I think is supposed to be a sculpting shade, I thought maybe was a highlight shade because it looks very similar to one of the highlight shades in the other palette. So, you know, like most face palettes, I don't think every single shade is going to work for one person, but I really like the looks of this warmer one with the peachy kind of blushes in the center. But it looks like those sculpting shades may be a little bit too deep for me, but the highlights look like they may work. So I'm not really sure. I'd like to see these in person, but I think it's tough to really get a sense of things in store now since you can't swatch. So by looking at these swatches, I think the cooler one actually would work for my skin tone a little bit better, but I just really like the blushes in the deeper ones. So we'll see, but I definitely want to pick up one of these. Burberry, I don't think has ever come out with a face palette, and I really do enjoy their products. So I'm really interested in this. And their highlighter, as you guys know, is I think, like, one of my all-time favorites, if not my ultimate favorite highlighter. So very excited for this. And definitely follow me on Instagram if you want to see updates, like when this does become available here in the US. Definitely follow me there. I like to, you know, just add new releases to my stories and onto my feed or whatever, just so you guys are aware of new releases. So that's the Burberry face palette. And then, oh yes, Pat McGrath. Yes. We have some new releases. I think we have dates, we have prices. So it looks like she is extending this like rose decadence collection that she, I think, started with Mothership palette number 7. And then she came out with number 2, which is Mothership 8. And now it looks like she's coming out with a 6-pan palette, which is the Mothership Rose Decadence eyeshadow palette. That's going to be $65. So that's the same price as her other 6-pan palettes. Lip Fetish Divinyl Lip Shine in 6 shades, 36 each. I think that's the one with the white casing. And then Lip Fetish Astral in 2 new shades for $36. That's in like the glittery case. And then, oh wow. And then the lip pencil, she's coming out with 10 new shades. Holy smokes. Those are 28 each. That's the same. Oh, and there's also a new Lip Fetish Sheer Color. Maybe that's what's in the white tube. I'm confused because in the caption for this Trend Mood post, there's 5 products listed, but there's only 4 pictured. So I'm not sure, but pretty sure I'm going to be getting most of this. Definitely getting the eyeshadow palette. I think I want to get the Lip Fetish Astrals. I really like those. They're a lot of fun. And it looks like they've updated the packaging. So the Lip Fetish Astrals and her Sheer, like lip balms, those used to come in, like the outer color was different, but basically it was the same as her lipstick. So it was like kind of like the normal lipstick size. These look like maybe they're a little bit more slender and a little bit taller. And then we have like the softer formula type of like bullet casing where there's like a slant tip to the top of the bullet. As far as I understand, the bullet casing where it's slanted at the top is for softer formulas so that you can put it on an angle and they don't break. I don't know if there was a formula change. I don't know, but I'm really excited for these. So yes, yes to all of this. I don't know how many of the lip pencils I'll be picking up. Probably not all 10 new shades, but I do like her formula. I do like the shades that she's already come out with. I pretty much have all of the ones that are existing. So yeah, I'm really excited for those. So a big yes to that for sure. So I feel like this is old news already, but I went online to try and purchase these, and some of the shades, well, most of the shades that I wanted were sold out already. So this is definitely something I want to pick up. These are the new M Cosmetics Color Drops Serum Blushes. And I have the 4 originals. They were kind enough in sending those to me, and I love them. I love a cream blush. I love a liquid blush. And these had like such an interesting, like they weren't thick in any way, but they had sort of like a gel squalane kind of like feel to them, and so they were just very, very unique, and I think the pigmentation went on really smoothly. So I was really excited for these, but I was just too late. I was too late to the website. So a lot of them are sold out, but I think once they're all in stock, I am definitely getting them. I'm really, really interested in that purple shade and the red shade. The other 2 shades look beautiful as well, but they look like, you know, more traditional blush shades. The 2 shades on the right hand side look very different, and I would love to play around with those. So definitely a big yes to these serum blushes, and they are $25 each, and they launched at the end of July. So I was definitely very, very slow to this. Oh, and an interesting, I guess kind of like skincare slash makeup product. This is from Peach & Lily. This is their Skin Shield Blurring Primer. It is to protect and smooth. And the founder and owner of Peach & Lily, she suffers from eczema, and so a lot of the products that she's developed for Peach & Lily are for very sensitive skin, which I have. So I'm very interested in this. It is a plant-based primer. It is powered by VoluSmooth, which leaves you with a smooth, blurred, cushiony finish with no silicones, while also fending off damage from daily stressors. So VoluSmooth is infused with Camu Camu to provide loads of vitamin C in a gentle format. because I can't generally use vitamin C, it really just sensitizes my skin and it just kind of activates my eczema. So I generally stay away from it. But this says specifically that it's in a gentle format, so that's exciting. Ceramides to fortify the skin barrier, and cica to calm, and aloe to soothe and refresh. It's 100% plant-based silicone alternative that's made up of three ingredients: bamboo stem extract, mulberry leaf extract, and burdock root extract. There's no fragrance, there's no scent, and it is $34. This is available now. I don't know where. I was really excited actually to see Peach and Lily available on Ulta.com because I think previously it was only available on their site, which is fine, but at least at Ulta, you know, you can get points and stuff. So I'm gonna see if this is at Ulta, but I'll link everything that is available now. I'll link it down below in my description box if you're interested. But that looks really promising to me. I'm gonna hop over to Chic Profile Official here on Instagram. This is another wonderful, wonderful Instagram feed. It looks like Charlotte Tilbury has come out with some new products. I actually woke up this morning and ordered them. So she's come out with Jewel Lips, which looks like a very shimmery high gloss lip formula in Pillow Talk and Walk of Shame. And then she's come out with Jewel Pots, which are, you know, her cream eyeshadows. They look like a different formula from her regular kind of like moussey cream eyeshadows. These look more like they're like a putty formula, almost like the Chanel or the Chantecaille, you know, like a denser kind of formula. And she's also come out with that in Pillow Talk and Walk of Shame. So Chic Profile Official has these listed in pounds. So the Jewel Lips is 22 pounds, the Jewel Pots, the eyeshadows, 24 pounds. I think in the US, the Jewel Pots are like 35 and the Jewel Lips are like 34. They were like in the mid to low $30 range. But anyway, I'm excited to give these a shot. Do these look revolutionary? You know, not really. These are like pinks and purples, glittery shades, but I really have been loving, I mean, I've always loved, you know, potted eyeshadows and single shadow looks, but like really, really loving it these days. Just the easier, the better. So I'm excited. I'm excited for this. And it looks like Tom Ford is coming out with some limited edition versions of the Satin Matte Lipstick. It's a set and it features three permanent shades, 1111, La Woman, and Narcissique. I am definitely passing on these. I do not like the Satin Matte formula. For much the same reason I don't like the Hourglass Confession lipsticks. Very silicone-y, they go on very pigmented, they go on super smooth. They feel great when you first apply them and then they dry down and I feel like they dry my lips out. So I'm definitely gonna pass on these, but wow, these look really beautiful. I love that limited edition gold packaging. It looks stunning. And then NARS is coming out with these cute little sets that I saw on Chic Profile Official's Instagram feed first. And I thought, oh wow, like, I wonder how they're selling these because everything looks kind of mini. So I didn't know if they're gonna be sold in sets or whatever. So lo and behold, they've popped up on the Nordstrom anniversary sale where you can get the compact with like the green lid and the little NARS Climax mascara, which is one that I've been dying to try. You can get that as a set. I ordered that. I'm really excited to give them a shot. Then you can get the clutch with three of the balms. What you see in the lower left-hand corner of the picture, that's available also. I don't know if that's part of the anniversary sale or if that's just available on Nordstrom now. And then I think what's also available on Nordstrom are two of those oil-infused lip tints that you see in the bottom right-hand corner. What I haven't seen is what is in the upper left-hand corner, which looks like a very bronzy kind of smaller palette, which very much appeals to me. And I really like NARS products. So if I see that, I'll probably pick that up too. But at the moment I skipped on the balms with the clutch and then I skipped on the oil-infused lip tints. They're very pretty. I may circle back and pick up, I think maybe the balms. Those are really easy to wear. They feel great on the lips. I have the Laguna one and I love it. So maybe I'll pick those up. But for the moment, I've only picked up the one with the green lid and the little NARS mascara. And then last but not least, I can't remember if I talked about this in my last Will I Buy It? I didn't think I did, and now that I'm looking at the picture, I'm getting a little bit of deja vu. But anyway, this is worth repeating because Hermes is coming out with new lipsticks, and these are launching in September. So there's gonna be three new shades. So Rose Ombre is a satin finish. Rose Nuit is a matte finish. I think that's the one on the left-hand side of the picture. That's the one that looks matte. And then Rose Pomme, P-O-M-E-T, Pomme, is a satin color. So all of these look great to me. I really like the shade that's in the middle. I think that's one that I would wear a lot. And the other two just look like really beautiful pinks. So big yes for me. Will I buy it? Definitely. All right, that is it for this Will I Buy It? Please let me know your thoughts on any of these new releases down below. Let me know if there's anything that really like stood out to you that you would love for me to purchase and review for you guys. Just let me know down below in the comment section. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe down below if you haven't already, and I'll see you in my next video.